everyone. Here in Canberra, we just finished a long weekend, so I've been away for a few days, but I'm back now, and we're up to Revelation 5 in my Bible plan, so that's what we're going to look at today. So grab your Bible, have a read of that, and let's have a look at it. Revelation 5 would have to be one of my favorite passages in the Bible. It's one of those passages that if I need some encouragement, this is the place to go. The imagery here is so beautiful. It's so meaningful. As I said, it's one of those places to go if you need to be encouraged, if you need to be reminded of who it is we follow as Christians. In general, a great way to view the book of Revelation is to understand it as kind of lifting up the curtain between our world and the spiritual world in a way that we can then see the reality that is normally unseen to the human eye. Now, we're not going to get mixed up in all the complexity of the imagery here because there's a lot going on. It's enough to say for now that pretty much if there's an image in Revelation, it is rooted in the Old Testament. This is a great and dramatic piece of literature. But of course it's more than that. But let's have a look at it. I mean, it starts with a scroll that obviously contains something very important. No one is worthy to open this scroll, and that makes John, who's sort of looking at all that's going on here, very sad. He weeps. And later we'll see that when the scroll is opened, God's plan of redemption and judgment is put into action. So it would seem that whoever can open this scroll is key to that plan. But in verse 5, then, we see that in verse 5, we see that one of the elders said to me, "Do not weep. See, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the Root of David, has triumphed. He is able to open the scroll and its seven seals." So we hear about the Lion of the tribe of Judah, and we expect then that John is going to turn around and see an all-conquering, powerful lion, king of the jungle. But of course, when he turns around, he sees something completely different. He sees a lamb, and not just a lamb, but a lamb who looks as if it has been slain. What on earth is going on there? Of course, it's a picture of Jesus, isn't it? Jesus, who is both the mighty Lion of Judah, again, imagery borrowed from the Old Testament, and the lamb that was slain. And as we can see by what follows, there's this eruption of praise when this lamb is revealed. First, those in the heavenly throne room cry out and explain what's going on. And they sing a new song saying, "You are worthy to take the scroll and to open its seals, because you were slain, and with your blood you purchased for God peoples from every tribe and language and people and nation. You've made them to be a kingdom and priests to serve our God, and they will reign on the earth." So we can see exactly what I said, that God's plan of redemption is enacted through the Lamb, through Jesus. And not only that, but specifically through the death of Jesus, through the blood of Jesus is the language used there. But then, as I said, the tension builds and this eruption of praise goes to the voice of many angels. And then finally, every creature in heaven and on earth and under the earth and in the sea and all that is in them give praise to the Lamb. What a picture. If you're feeling discouraged, come back to this. If you're doubting God's in control in our current situation, come back to this. If you're worried about death at the moment, come back to this. Jesus is the Lion and the Lamb, the one who is key to God's plan, the one whose blood rescued people from every tribe and language and people and nation, the one who is worthy of all honor and glory and praise forever. Amen.